This famously is known as the Theatre of Dreams. A very warm welcome to Old Trafford. So, here we go then. Juventus against Manchester United.
It's John Champion here at the microphone, and alongside me we have a top football analyst in Jim Begley.
Hi John, it's been a great buzz here since I sat in my seat. I think this promises something special today.
Marquisio, onside, Tevez, big moment, big goal.
And some of the best managers I played for insisted on starting games as you mean to go on. And we've just seen a very important opening goal from an extremely talented individual who looks primed for more. He really does look at it.
He'd love to play against defenders as charitable as that every week.
Tevez just knew instinctively where...
They've helped themselves to a two-goal advantage in no time at all.
Tevez showed real composure then. I mean, how often do you see a player do everything right until he gets into the box, only to completely kind of fluff the finish? Not him.
Now it's 2-0.
Well, that goal makes such a difference to the whole dynamic of this game. That second goal puts him in control now.
And now there's a platform for a counter-attack. Pogba, can he now find a finish? And again, couldn't make it.
Juventus have been enjoying as good an attacking spell as you could wish for, and yet they've been incredibly wasteful. I mean, they could have wrapped it up by now, and it's not going right for them.
That is wayward.
He knows very well he can score from that distance. Not quite this time.
It's Mata, Valencia, Juan Mata. Two goals already to his name, and space on his mantelpiece for a match ball.
Yeah, well, when you assess how he's gone about his business up to now, he looks driven and determined, and enough to complete his hat-trick. I think he's going to get it.
Pirlo, that is great goalkeeping. Pirlo will drive this corner in. Tevez! 3, and that may just about be that. He offers such presence from set pieces.
Yeah, I just thought he wanted that more than anyone else on the pitch, and it was fully deserved. He gave it everything he had.
He'll be taking the match ball home.
Oh, he's been unstoppable in this match. Every single time he's been in possession, he's looked a threat.
We resume again. The score is 3-0. Looking to exploit the space. And he's been given offside.
Oh, that was just fractionally offside.
That's a clever ball from him. Chiellini plays it into the danger area. Incisive pass that. Fabio Azamar. He's onside. Oh, that should have been there four.
Well, there's no messing about with this fella, is there? Just went straight down the middle. If only he could have applied the finish with the same conviction.
Tevez! Cleared away. On his own. Off he goes. Here's Van Persie. Play surges forward. Manchester United have a free kick for that. Rooney. The whistle goes and it's the end of the first half. So, three goals separate the sides. I wonder what the final score's going to be. Looking to play on the break. The ball played through the middle. Ander Herrera. Valencia. Johnny Evans, looking to carve open the defence.
Pogba.
Cuadro Azamor. Couldn't quite get it through that.
Yeah, it looked like there that he was asking just a little too much of himself to try and thread that ball through. He was a bit overambitious, but I like his thinking.
Juventus, still not utilising their bench. Plays it wide towards the byline. Rooney! Well, everything was right there except the finish. Cuadro Azamor. No, the defence alerts and picked out the danger. He's bursting forward. The lob. Surely this one off target.
Well, it looks like the control just deserted him at the final moment. I mean, to say you got a poor connection, that's an understatement.
We've reached the last 15 minutes of the game. And now Marchisio. No, he's not getting through this time. Van Persie,
Rooney,
Van Persie, Pirlo, Cuadro Azamor, looking to receive the ball, break could be on, full time whistle within sight, here's Van Persie, a really well-taken goal. They're now back within two. Well, what can you say about that goal?
Well, considering he has a bit of a shoot-on-sight policy, he was the one player that should have been picked up then. It was both careless and costly from where I'm sitting.
They restart with the deficit now narrowed to two. And that comes as a mighty relief. He wasn't far from finding the net again.
Yeah, he's definitely a player who looks like he could make something happen every time he's on the ball. He's just full of belief and energy.
And the decision is offside. There it is, the final whistle. Simply magnificent.